Nicholas Koshiaris. First of all, he was close on bald. He had like a number one shaved haircut, so he looked very close to a convict. He was sitting with his aunt at a table in the corner, and he was very cocksure of himself. And when I said, you know, do you guys want your role? You know, the good manager that I am. He said to me, yeah, and just put your phone number on it while you're at it. I heard that he was the owner's nephew, so I'm like, oh well, I'm going to lose my job, might as well carry on with my life. And I didn't. And I saw him again. I think it was 6 months later, 8 months later. And he was with his cousin. I was very good friends with his cousin, and she invited me for lunch at 3 o'clock, and she never told me that she was with him. I thought I'd never have come, and I pitched up, and there he was, and she proceeded to get up straight away from the table and leave us on our own. And I remember I offered him one of my cigarettes, because he smoked, I think, Winston Blue at the time, and he finished them, and I offered him one of my cigarettes, and he said, no thanks. I thought, fine, sod, don't take one of my snakes. And then we got to talking, and Angie found me afterwards and told me that her cousin liked me. And I said to her, no, tell me the truth, is he a player? And because of Angie's lie, a very, very good lie of, no, of course my cousin's not a player, he's not one of those guys, I went on a date with him. And the rest, as they say, is
something about the way the hair falls in your face. I love the shape you take when crawling towards the pillowcase. You tell me where to go, and though I might leave to find it, I'll never let your hand hit the bed without my hand behind it. You want love, we'll make it. Swim in a deep sea of blankets. Take all your big plans and break them. This is bound to be a wild. Your body's a wonderland. Your body's a wonder. I'll use my hands. Your body's a wonderland.
My cousin Angie used to work at my uncle's restaurants, or her father's restaurants in Papas in Boxburg. And I was like dumb or dumb, didn't have a job, didn't have anything. And then she asked me to pick up from somewhere, I can't remember where. And I picked up, and we were on our way back to Santon. And she said, we were there by Linksfield, she said, do you want to go for lunch? I was like, okay, cool. And we made a U-turn. I mean, I didn't really feel like, she's like, it's up to you. I said, oh, okay. And I made a big detour, went all the way back to Boxburg. Then I met Dale. But a year prior to that, I met her in the same restaurant. She was our waiter. I was with my aunt, and I asked her to put a phone number on the bill, and she told me to fuck off. But a year later, she came out.